out of this spot a lot last week. Every time I was in here, saw a box right below here is where I was having an encounter with that really wide 8-point. He came up the hill right here where I'm sitting. Had that 3-point come off the top here, and then I had like a 6 or 7-point run this ridge out. This entire hillside below me is just dug up like crazy. Even last week it was dug up when there wasn't snow. Now that there's snow, you can just see this whole entire hillside is tore up from deer digging up acorns. But I know they bet on this top up here. So I'm set up here. There's good trails up here. I got this point that comes out. Bedding area out here on the thick Mount Morrill. I got this ridge behind me. Acts as a funnel right here. Got the wind in my face like this. It's all bedding all through this top. So we'll see. It's freaking cold. It's windy. I did a really good job of getting sweaty on the way in here. We'll see if a mountain buck wants to walk in front of me today. Out of the wind, and if I was a deer, I would not want to be bedded here. This sucks. Out here about 1/2 mile the leeward side of the mountain, on the north side, because we have a south wind today. And I remember in shed season, I walked that and I found an amazing spot, and I cannot believe I forgot about it until right now. There's some pines on the ridge up there. There was a ton of deer bedded there. And I gotta get over there. It's 1/2 mile as the crow flies over there. But I gotta climb down the mountain here on the east side, walk the bottom, get on the north side, and then walk straight up that mountain and set up there. I can't just walk across this top. I'll spook a bunch of deer. I'm gonna get down. I'm so cold. I'm gonna get down. We're gonna go set up over there. All right, so it's like 9:30 now. I went down the mountain, followed the bottom. Now I'm coming up this creek bottom, heading up to the mountain. I needed to climb 600 more feet in elevation straight up this. There's no way anybody has touched this all season. It is so remote from every access. There's really no deer sign. There's like no deer tracks on this whole mountainside, but I know as soon as I get up there, there's gonna be deer sign. But yeah, like I said, 600 feet straight up and we're there. Made it up to the top. I expect to see more deer tracks, but there's only 2 sets of tracks, and they're really big. One set's really big, right here, and they were definitely from this morning in the daylight. They came from over there. This is all my 3 favorite things all in one. Mount Morrill, oak trees, pine trees. I love this. And some ridges here. I think I'm gonna walk up there where I have a pin marked, where I marked some big rubs, kind of get up on that next flat, and we'll see what's up. There's bobcat tracks, there's fox tracks on that mountainside, coyote tracks, and I saw bear tracks as well, so it's crazy. It's a little after 10 o'clock. Got set up on this ridge. Ended up finding where a bunch of deer tracks met in here. Climbed up this tree, it's nice. There's a big pine tree right here, give me some cover. Opened my bag to see what my lunch looked like. Seen better days. And got normally I get a McChicken, but I figure I'd get a Big Mac because they come in cardboard. I figure it wouldn't get it smashed. But she'll eat. I can't believe I do this kind of stuff. Rap. just had the biggest buck, one of the biggest bucks I've ever seen in my life, at 15 yards.
Man.
I couldn't get him to stop. My camera wouldn't focus either. Huge buck. That doe was hot. There was another 4-point behind her. I got a film of him, but I thought it was like a raven. I'm sure you guys heard that sound that buck was making. I thought it was a raven. It was just like, meh. I thought it was over here, and I'm waiting for this raven to fly over me. There's all this crashing behind me. I look, and there's a huge buck. He looked like a massive 8 or 7 point or something. Oh, man. That's a freaking heartbreaker. They're running around like crazy, though. They could easily come back. But, man, you just want to punch a tree right now. I'm not going to shoot at that deer. He's drunk. Filming that little broke up 8-point. He walked. I passed him up. I had him at 15 yards. He walks out there. I hear more crashing down there. That's a huge buck. He's just running around back and forth like an idiot. And then he comes up to this little buck 40 yards from me. And then he just looks it that way, starts grunting like crazy. And that 8-point that I passed up, the little one, goes down there. It's 11:30. Believe all that just happened. There's 3 days left of the archery season here in Pennsylvania. This whole season I've been after a mature buck. And to have one at 15 yards and not get it done really sucks. I know that was a really big buck, but he's not the biggest one. I know there's bigger bucks in here. He was a beautiful, beautiful buck. What happened? He chased that doe up there, and it's so thick in here, I think the doe kind of got away from him. So he just started running around here like an idiot looking for her. And I think eventually he smelled her over there, chased after her, and then she started running the ridge out to me. I think she got my wind because I heard her blow twice and I must have went down the mountain, but she was definitely a hot doe. There was 3 bucks behind her. I wouldn't be surprised if there was more coming. Never know. Got like 6 hours of daylight left. Keep my head up. You never know what you'll see. You never know what you'll see in the woods. Very thankful for that encounter. That was really awesome. Hopefully I got good video. My camera's been having trouble focusing. I know it was unfocused, but I know that buck walked into the frame, so maybe I'll be back. I just watched the video back. And it was really tough to tell how big that buck was in the video, but I swear it was big. It was huge. My camera, for some reason, has just been having a lot of trouble focusing lately. And I have to like zoom in and out a bunch of times before it focuses finally. I didn't have time to do it. cannot believe what just happened. Oh my god. That's the buck I've been chasing all season. I found his shed down over this mountain about a mile and a half last March. I've been getting pictures of him every week since August. And that is the second time I've ever seen him in person. The first time I saw him in velvet, and that's how I knew where he was living in here. I scored his sheds last year at 134 inches, and that's guessing the spread. He is way bigger this year as an 8-point. I cannot believe I saw him. I've seen 3 big bucks today. I looked down there was a doe. Then I could hear grunting and crashing behind her. Then a nice buck popped out. I thought it was that buck from earlier, but it was a completely different nice buck. And then I hear a snort wheeze. And I knew exactly who it was when I saw him. Chased that other buck off. The doe came over here, followed the ridge, and then both of those bucks came. I had the big 8 at 40 yards through some really thick stuff. I'm so thankful to see that buck. I've seen 3 big bucks today. Well, they got a few more minutes of daylight. I only ended up seeing one more deer around 2:30. Couldn't tell what it was that worked this top above me. Awesome day. I saw 5 bucks, 2 little ones, 2 huge ones, and 1 kind of in the middle. I'm so happy I saw that really, really big 8-point. I can't believe that happened. Got 2 more days of the PA archery season. I got a little bit of time to hunt tomorrow, and then Saturday I'll probably be up here all day going after one of these big bucks. Fingers crossed. So a little bit after I shut the camera off saying it was, the hunt was over, I hear something coming down the hill, and I stopped shooting late now. He came down to 15 yards, stood right where that doe stood earlier. I could have shot him, but I don't know. I was trying to figure out how big he was. It looked like a pretty nice 7-point. And then he turned, and he was walking right below me, and I was going to shoot him right here at 3 yards, but he caught my scent. I can't shoot because there's this pine. There he's blowing at me. What a jerk. He just blew at it. He wanted to get downwind of me to see what I was. What a jerk. Oh well. Alright, now it's the end of the night. Time for a 2.5 mile walk out of here. And that makes 6 bucks. I saw today and 4 of them. I would have shot. Unreal. Unreal.
And that's why I ate McDonald's in the tree stand. Almost 8 miles today, 100 floors walked up, 842 calories. I'm sure I burn more calories because I have that tree stand on my back. Crazy day.